Okay, so it's been about 3 or 4 months since I've started playing Elite Dangerous, and a couple of you have wanted an update, so I thought, why not? And I've also had a request for a bit of gameplay, so I might as well throw in an introduction because you've also asked for some kind of small tutorial, so let's chuck them all in together. So basically, at this point, I have joined the Federation, and I am stationed at Nanoman, which is the Federation home base. And this game, there's quite a lot to do. So any kind of tutorial I give you, generally you'll find a tutorial on mining. I don't know if there's any tutorials on piracy, bounty hunting, exploration, all kinds of things. Generally, what I kind of do is get myself, I've got a few different ships for a few different things at the moment. What we're in at the moment is a Cobra, and it's kind of set up for a little bit of just, having a fun time, a mix of everything. So I've got some weapons, I've got some mining equipment, and some fuel scoops for exploration. So if you're first starting out, a couple of things I recommend is getting a very comfy chair and getting yourself nice and relaxed, because this game does take a bit of time. When you hop into it, it's not just 20 minutes, 30 minutes here, there, or anywhere. You pretty much have to spend maybe an hour if you want to do anything exciting. So, being stationed at Nanomam, I thought we'll venture out a little bit. Now, I've gone below the bubble, and what that is the bubble is the Galactic Powers. So as you can see, there's different factions fighting over different areas in the universe, and this is the most of populated space. There's a lot of people out there in the fringes, but this is where the majority of us are. So if we go into, I'll show you how to use these later, into our bookmarks. We can see Nanomam. I've booked that, bookmarked that, so you can pick a spot. We'll pick this one for some reason, and we can bookmark it. And if you know where it is, Landy, you can edit it, so you can type in whatever it is you want to type in. Whole bunch of that. Save it. And then you can either plot route, and I'm just going to delete that. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go to where I'm stationed, which is, I've labeled this below the bubble because this is the last station I've found going down from the human populated space. So this is right on the fringe of where the stations are. So bookmarks do come in handy when you're doing something a little bit risky like this, and playing Elite Dangerous, it is a dangerous game. It's in the name. So you might as well go and venture out. Now, as for gameplay, what we're going to do, I've been a bit further down than this, so I've bookmarked a little spot that I want to check, because as I was going down and coming back up, I was doing scans through the systems, and I'll show you how to do that. And I found an interesting little planet that I'd like to visit, and it's nestled nicely between these asteroid belts. So I'll show you how to do a little bit of mining here. So what we're going to do is we're going to visit this planet, see what it looks like. Now, as you can see, there's no blue around it. Generally, if you see blue, that means that it has an atmosphere, you can land on it. This one, it doesn't look like we can land on it, but it does look very different from the rest. So I'm kind of eager to have a look and give it a bit of a scan. So what we can do is we'll go to the unexplored bookmark, plot route. And as you can see, these last two stretches of the jump are dotted lines. That means we're going to be out of fuel by the time we get there. So what we're going to do, we're going to have a look at this little area here, check what kind of a star we've got. And it looks like we should be able to refuel at these. And there's a couple of planets you can land on. See, you've got the little blue ring around it. says it's got atmosphere, so we can land on those. But we won't be visiting them today. So, what we're going to do is we'll just make sure we did plot route down there. Yep, we did. And we're going to take off. Now, if you do join a faction, which you might at some point, because it does add a interesting layer to Elite Dangerous, you'll need to start taking notice of which systems are hostile, which systems are in anarchy, which are part of your alliance as well, because it can be quite dangerous going through some of those areas, and if you're exploring, sometimes you do need to stop there. So generally at this point I'd probably have an MP3 player going. So you'd want to put on some music, just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. Okay, so that was the first jump. Now, if we have a look at your systems on the left, you can see that there's 9 jumps to where we need to go. And it's just there on the left side, down the middle, where it says route. Now, there's a couple of things we can do here. We can open up the system map and have a look and see if there's anything here. So, looks like I've come through and scanned here before and found this planet. Because not all planets are visible, even if they have been found. You need to purchase that information when you're at a station through Universal Cartographics. So, see this little planetary map? That information gets updated when you scan those planets. So, the way you scan is, if you see on the left side, I have a D scanner. If you hold the button for that, which would be secondary fire for this. No new astronomical objects found. So we've found everything the way I'm pointing, I guess. You have to be lucky. Sometimes when you point it out into deep space, you'll find something that wasn't there before. And if you're the first person to find it, you will get to name it. Or it'll be named after you, first discovered by whoever. Alright, so we've got 9 jumps. And we'll make that 8. So if you jump into a star system that's in the populated space, or it's in a system that has stations there, there should be a nav beacon that orbits the star that you jumped in at. Now if you scan that, which is just your basic, select it for scanning, or select it like selected item, I'm not sure what the button is in the menu, it'll automatically download the system information for you. Now this is why you need a fuel scoop. Now I don't know if I've mentioned this before, if we get close enough this sun might burn us up before we start refueling actually. Yeah, it looks like it, so we're not going to worry about it. That's a bit dangerous. Alright, so we'll open up the system map. We've got 4 suns here, 4 stars. So I've scanned that as I've gone past, and as you can see there's orbit lines, so there's going to be suns orbiting other suns, so it's a fairly dangerous solar system here. Alright, so we've got 8 jumps to go. We're going to bring it down to 7. So it's just handy, when you get a bit bored, to look at your little system notifications there on the left. Because it can take a little while depending on where you're going. It looks like we could probably refuel at this sun. Yep. Alright, so while we're refueling, let's have a look over here. Now this is where it gets a little bit adventurous. So there's your modules, you can change things here. Switch them off, switch them on. That's rather complicated. That's when you need to start worrying about power consumption, as well as a few other things. Fire groups, that's fairly easy to understand. If you want to create a fire group, so I'll set that as primary fire, secondary fire, or I've already got one set up, so I'll just delete them. And it goes up and down, that's easy fixed. Inventory, so I've got bauxite and uraninite that I've got from mining previously, and this is what's in the hoppers in my refinery at the moment. So generally what happens is when you're just checking the heat now, when you're mining, you will pick up a block of material that could have maybe two or three different chemical elements in there, and that'll fill up your hopper depending on the percentage of how much of that item you have. So I've got 69% of gallite, 36% of indite. These are all from a few different slabs, and every time that marker reaches 100%, it'll give you 1 ton of that chemical in your cargo. So you need a cargo hold, you need a refinery. More expensive refineries, like the one I have about 9 hoppers. Cheaper ones generally have about 4 or 5, but the more hoppers you have, the more or bins you have, the more you can kind of work on these little elements here. Otherwise you have to discard some of those elements, and you don't want to do that. So why would you mine? Apart from the obvious, you know, you can sell these chemicals over the market, you can also go to synthesis. So if we got stuck in space, you can, you know, increase your, there we go, done. You can increase your jump distance. You can get better weapons or better ammunition for your weapons. So say for instance, you wanted premium plasma munitions. If you get all of these, oops, if you get all of these chemicals here, you can make ammunition that'll give you a 30 plus damage, or you can go for the easier to find ones that get like a 15%+ damage increase on your weapons there. So you can do some pretty cool stuff that can keep you alive in some instances. If you need to jump out of you need to do like a bigger jump, or you need to extend your fuel, do that kind of stuff, you can sometimes save your own butt doing it that way, which can be quite exciting depending on what it is you're doing. If you're out in the middle of deep space, you know, you're somewhere like 100 jumps away from the last space station, it can get fun. Alright, so when you jump into a star, if you have a look around the star, you can generally find, not into the star, look around the star, you can generally find a nav beacon, but because we're in non-populated space, there is no nav beacon here. However, I have seen an unexplored item here. Alright, so I managed to catch these when I did a scan before, so let's just have a quick look at the system map. Which ones are unexplored? Unexplored, 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 unexplored. They're all unexplored, so I'd need a surface scanner to get more data on those. I don't have a surface scanner at the moment, so We're just going to ignore that. So I haven't done much piracy, but generally I like to do some mining and transport. I've also got like a Type 6 transporter that sometimes I'll fill up full of all kinds of junk and just jump around the human populated area of space and just do deliveries, and that can get... Actually, it's really fun. You put on some music and do your thing. Oh, I remember scanning this. I was quite impressed because when I first jumped in, I had only this star. I did a scan and it found another star and all these planets here, a whole bunch of them. See, as you can see, they've already been found by someone, but I haven't purchased the information from star systems, so I never had them. And we're just going to wait for this to load so you can see what this looks like. The surface scanner, so it's just got to connect and download it and do its thing, and I have really poor internet, so it's not going to work at the moment. But you can see what's on the surface, what you can mine in the little SRV. So I have a Scarab. So if you purchase a vehicle holder for your ship, you can put a little buggy in there, and then you can ride the buggy on the planets that have atmosphere. And I really like the effect of flying away from stars, because it makes the other stars so much brighter. You really get that light pollution effect. Okay, this is white. No, it's just a really bright star. So you're not going to see any nav beacons out here at the edge of space. So unfortunately we won't be able to scan it, but you'll get the gist of it when you see the nav beacon there. So we've got how many jumps? 4 jumps to do, so just bear with me for a little bit. Alright, let's have a look at this system. Alright, so it doesn't look like there's anything here, so I'll show you what it looks like if we find anything. So I'm just going to slow down and scan some of this empty space, and if we're lucky, we'll hit something. One new astronomical object. Alright, so let's have a look and see what the change is. Oh, look, we found a planet. So Von Beck has found this before we have, and we didn't have this information already because, as I said, I didn't purchase it from a space station. Because when people go out exploring, they will actually scan space, and if they find any planets, it'll go into their data systems. They can bring the data systems back to a station, and then they can sell it to Universal Cartographics, from which anyone can buy that information. However, I'm going into space, and I haven't space that I haven't actually scanned or purchased the data for, so I'm doing the scans myself. It's kind of pointless really, but it's free. But you might not pick everything up as well. You might be missing something, or you could actually be picking up something new that no one's ever found before. So that's the joy of it, you know. It's a very interesting kind of way of going about things. So definitely have to try exploring at some point if you really want to enjoy what this game's about, especially going through, you know, if you join a faction and you have to go through, you know, hostile systems and systems in anarchy, It's very interesting. But I wouldn't expect that we're going to come across many people in this. I'm actually doing it on solo play. So if there's anyone in here, it would be AI. But I doubt we'll come across anyone. Alright, so we should be getting close. And I'm running out of fuel, so while we do that, I'll show you how to do a fuel scoop. So you can either sit here and sip it off the star, which can come in handy when you've got other things to do, like looking at your stuff and checking all your things and, you know, yada yada yada. Or, depending on the star, I find that most of the time, if you sit at about 9 megameters a second or something like that, you can generally get a good flow going. Now, see how it's going 62, 63, 64, and it's counting all the way up? It'll get to about 75. That's the maximum mine can absorb, and it's a fairly decent fuel scoop for the class of aircraft. Class of spaceship that we're in at the moment. We're at 76 degrees, that's a bit hot, so I'm just going to pull out a little bit. 81, is that going to go down at all? 79, there we go, that's not too bad. So you can get a decent flow if you just keep the speed quite low in your super cruise. But like I was saying, my fuel scoop is actually quite a good fuel scoop. So you might not get up to 75, so don't be too stressed out. You need to learn the maximum of what it can do when you purchase it. Otherwise, if you're going to try and get 75 out of a lower grade fuel scoop, you're going to end up in the sun. So don't do that, because that's not good. And I don't recommend it. Alright, so that's about enough for now. And you can do it a few different ways. You can, you know, skim around like this, like a fool. There's plenty of things you can do for your fuel scooping. There's many a different way to skin a cat. So, we're about 2 jumps off. Let's just make this jump, because I've given you the ins and outs. Now, I don't recommend starting a frame shift jump when you're fuel scooping, because that does increase your temperature by about 8 degrees, I think. Sometimes you can end up causing some major damage. And we're at our destination. So, if we check our little system map, we can see that this is selected. So it'll appear on our HUD where to go. And I just want to check if I can fuel here. Yes. So we just need a bit of fuel. Now we're pretty close, because I'm not going anywhere, and we're scooping at about 61. So I'm hoping this is a generally cold star rather than a hot one. Well, heat seems to be sticking at 65, so we're kind of safe. Alright, that should do for now. Right, now these lines you can see as well, we can switch them off. So if you go into your functions, you go to orbit lines off. You can get rid of them, so it's kind of more like simulating space. But I prefer them on at the moment. But I do go through my phases. So this is what we're going to have a look at. Now, I don't have a surface scanner, so we're just going to be looking at this very interesting looking. Look at that! I've never seen anything like that, to be honest. That's the first time I've seen it. So we can't actually land on the planet. Let's see how close we can get to these. What is that, lava? Looks like it's got some kind of active volcano kind of deal going on here. Knowing my luck, it'll have like a massive gravitational pull. But that definitely is some interesting looking planet. Dropping too close. Yeah, so we can't land on it, but we will drop out of. So it'd take 6 hours to reach the surface from here. That's kind of pointless. So what we'll do after we've had a look at this very interesting planet is move on to some mining. Right, so we want to get to that over there. Oh. We're caught up with the gravitational pull of the planet, so. See, look at that, and not all the suns are the same as well, so that's got like a solar ejection coming out of it. It looks magnificent. But the cool thing is, you know, it's not, you know, you see all these awesome pictures of space and whatnot sent back from NASA. In this, you can kind of fly past it. It's really cool. Unidentified signal source. All right. So we're just going to scan that. Degraded emissions detected. Zero threat. All right. So we're going to drop into this and just see what it is. Just for those who are curious. Usually what it is this kind of destroyed ship floating around. Kind of dangerous to fly around in. Now, if you were to drop into a nav beacon, you'd see the same kind of thing. See how there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's, you know, six little white things here. You can lock onto each of them, but when you're in a nav beacon area, what you'll be locking onto is the nav beacon, and that's all you need to do. Just leave it like that, and it will scan and download all your details. For the system that you're in. Now, if I was to pick these up, that would be illegal. That's counted as illegal activity. And I would be marked as a pirate if my ship was scanned. So we're not going to do that. Now, myself, I don't do much pirating. However, it does seem like a very interesting way to play the game because, you know, they move in shady circles. And you can only park at certain stations and stuff. Because not all stations will do business with a pirate, so you really have to be careful where you go. Now, this screws me up sometimes because I don't have all the buttons set for selecting certain system items. That doesn't make sense. So if I was to push one button, it would lock onto my next jump location, but there's also another button that you can press that will lock onto items in the solar system that you've selected in the map, because obviously when you're going about your business you need to select certain things. So as you can see, I'm scanning at the moment. Okay, so it's a belt cluster. I wonder if we can do that with the sun, or we need a surface scanner for that. Oh, this is going to be dangerous. So my heat's going to be quite... it's staying at about 55. So we might be able to survive in this asteroid cluster here. Just need to get a little bit closer. But if we jump out of cruise, we'll stop refueling. Because you can only refuel in super cruise. So we'll drop out. Okie dokie. So we've got some bits and pieces here. I'll just bring out our stuffs. Now, what's also handy is if you have a few different buttons set. So I've got my rudder pedals, but my rudder pedals not only roll on an axis, but I've also got a left foot, which will push me back, and a right foot, which will push me forward, kind of like a car. You know, you've got your accelerator and decelerator, and that does come in handy. You're going to need another button to change your weapons. So the mining lasers now are primary. Alright, we've got Indite and Presodominium. And don't mind all this, you know, swirly stuff. That swirly stuff that you see is my missiles trying to lock onto it. So if we were to change to just the mining lasers, you won't see that on the HUD anymore. So what we need to do is line up. So that little blue box down there on the left. Line up. Scooch in. Line ourselves up. There is an easier way to do this, and it does take a while for me to get in a roll though, in order to do it. So let's have a quick look. Inventory, refinery. All right. Gold. Ooh, there's gold here, my friends. I don't know whether I should hide where this is or not. And it's easy to screw it up, so it does take a little while for me to... Alright, so there's some rumbles going on. what we're going to do. We're going to put the cargo scoop up. We're going to change to cannons. And we're going to scan these guys and have a look. Okay, so he's harmless. Scanning. Lawless. What's this guy? Lawless. What's this guy? Lawless. Lawless, no faction. Alright, let's not worry about that. If any of them said wanted, I'll show you how to do some bounty hunting. So, I mean, this is just the average day. anything can happen. I mean, heaven forbid you be here. And all of a sudden you get... Oh, jeez. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. So you could be here doing this, and then all of a sudden a capital ship will come out of nowhere. And, you know, the chances of that are highly unlikely, but it could happen. Anything can happen. Oh, look, I don't care anymore about him. Oh, yeah, I forgot. We've got another one of these rocks out in space. And it's got gold in it. And you don't want to go too fast because that knocks it around. And then you can't pick it up. Oh, you Schnerius? What is going on today? Generally, I'm not too bad with it, but... I'm going to hit this rock before I... Processing. Okay. Now, where's my... There it is. Gold. Gold. Gold's probably not the highest price commodity here, but, you know, we'll have a look. Okay. So if we go into the refinery, all of my hoppers are full by the looks of it. And if we wanted to eject any of them, you just hit that button. It'll empty the hopper, and then you can start picking up a different kind of chemical. Or material, or whatever it is you're looking for. So generally there's a pretty... you can kind of make it come to you if you do it the right way. And it makes mining less of a pain for the average Joe. Unless you want to go out and get, you know, mining limpets and, you know, go the whole hog. Whereas I'm just kind of like a casual miner, so it doesn't bother me. I just do it for fun. Alright, so what are we going to get here? We'll try one more. Iron. I don't have any iron. However... Hey, there's two here. I got two for the price of one. Cargo acquired. There we go. See that down in the bottom left? What did we get? New material discovered. Oh, iron. Let me see what you have. See, and this is why you need to keep weapons on you, because someone's scanning me. Alright, so he wants $1,000 worth of cargo, which I'm not willing to give him. So we got two options. We can turn and fight, or we can boot it. And I'm booting it. So, there you go. That's mining in a nutshell, and that's why you either take a wingman with you, or you have weapons. Now, I probably could have taken him, but rather than turn around and have a fight, I'm going to boot it. So, you've done your exploring, you need to get home. What do you do? You find a station that you like, or join up with a faction, and then you can add that to your bookmarks. So, Grizzly Dock, that's where I live. Plot route. Okay, so I'm ready to head home. 30 jumps. So I hope this has been a decent instructional video. It hasn't really covered everything. In closing, I'd recommend exploring. That's where you're going to learn the most. Get yourself a fuel scoop and a refinery and maybe one mining laser. Just explore. Just go on an adventure, because even just flying around is gameplay. Anything can happen. And this is Lieutenant Rabbit from the ship Homebound. Thank you for watching.